there's a guy named Jimmy Reed, who was the number one best-selling rhythm and blues artist of the 1950s. Everyone knows Jimmy Reed. All his songs go. Chuck Berry did the same. All of Jimmy Reed's songs do that rhythm. I mean, I've looked for some that do something. Some go fast, some go slow. But anyway, this is a tribute to the great man, because the Long Riders were once in New Orleans, Louisiana. And I bought a single called Tribute to Sonny, because Sonny Boy Williamson had died. And Jimmy Reed, back in 65, cut a record in tribute to his friend, the bluesman, Sonny Boy Williamson. On the record, Jimmy Reed, before he sings, "Hey, Sonny, blah, 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 we're sorry you're gone." You hear this voice go. And then Jimmy Reed would sing. And it turns out Jimmy Reed couldn't read or write. And it was his wife whispering the words to the song. And she would sing, "Say this, blah, 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 blah." And he would then sing, "Say this, blah, 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 blah." So I got a crazy song out of it. It's about Jimmy Reed. I love Jimmy Reed's music a great deal. I'm not making fun of him at all. I cherish the man. This is my song about Jimmy Reed, called, funny enough, Jimmy Reed.
Watching a good
I know it's obnoxious
to hear this coming through the PA. I'm sorry about that. If Fred wants to turn it off for a second, that's fine. I gotta tune it up. It's a 12 string that I just got from Norm's Rare Guitars. From my friend Norm in California. I was out there. I'll tell you, if I told you what I was doing, you wouldn't believe me. So I was out there and I traded in a couple of guitars and then wrote a small check and got this good guitar. Bless Norm's cotton socks. Fred, you took it out, didn't you? And I'm sorry I can't say the whole name. That's why I've anglicized it to Fred. I've Americanized your name to Fred. But I say that with respect, Fred. Okay. I know there's a lot of songs I know that nobody knows, so let me do a song that everybody, not everybody, but a lot of you here know. I lived in Southern California, and I had a band called The Unclaimed, and they were, believe it or not, a popular band in Southern California, nowhere else in the world. You know, we played the Whiskey A Go-Go and Gazzari's and The Mask and all these famous places there. And we broke two of us left the band. The band's going now. But two of us left the band, a guy named Barry Shank and myself, to form what evolved into this band, The Long Riders. And I remember Barry and I were we were writing songs already, but a lot of them weren't very good. So we wrote a few things, and Barry said, come over to my house, and he played me this song. The first time I heard this song, I thought it was great. The first time I heard it, I thought it was great. It was Barry on the sofa singing, playing. Years later, we recorded it with the Long Riders, and a wonderful man from the Byrds named Gene Clark sang him the song. And just about a year ago, Mojo Magazine in London had a compilation of I don't know what it was, 12-string songs or maybe Paisley Underground Bands, but they put this song on their compilation record. And it was in the movie, the Hollywood movie, I think it was Prozac Nation. I was asleep on the sofa and I woke up and heard this coming off the TV and I thought, what? But it wasn't the movie, it was in the film. And anyway, this is the song, it's called Ivory Tower. Let's see if I remember how it goes.
Boy. Thank you all very much. I really appreciate that. Let me, I'll come back to those happy days. Let me do a song just for the hell of it that I didn't write that I love very much. It was on my second solo record, The Trick is to Breathe, the blue cover. And I think it's a great piece of material. I used to live in a house, as I was telling at dinner to my dear Italian friends, I used to live in a house with some musicians in it. Now, only one of us became famous. Debbie Peterson of the Bangles became famous with hit records like Manic Monday and Walk Like an Egyptian. I didn't get to become famous. Billy Bremner from Rockpile was famous a couple of times, but at the end of the day, he's not really famous. Oh, Eric Burdon and the Animals lived there for a while. That's a good name to drop. Thump. And various people stayed. It was a wonderful neighborhood. Steve Wynn lived nearby. Ben Montench, the Heartbreakers, lived nearby. Dwight Yoakam lived nearby. Vicki Peterson of the Bangles lived nearby. I lived on a street called West Norton, and on a street called Genesee, which was just about six doors down, that was the cross street, Genesee. John Doe of the wonderful band X lived there with his then wife, Xene Cervenka. So it was a neighborhood full of musicians and writers and actors. It was Hollywood, you know. I'm sure that neighborhood's still full of those kind of people. And this is a song that I'd get frustrated. I'd go in my room and play records, and hardly anyone ever bothered me. And one time I played this record by this wonderful group, and there was this at the door, and I opened the door, and it was Debbie Peterson, the Bangles blonde, wonderful drummer, my friend. And she said, "What was that? It sounds like the Beatles. It's great." Here is the song that Debbie got excited when I was playing on the stereo in my room. It was on my second solo album. I think I've got it over there.
Cause you told me down. hear, what's that, TV in the background? Is that the football game? The football game?
You know, when you're in Europe and it's football season, it's a wise move not to turn down or turn off the TV. If you're really smart and from America, don't even ask who's playing. And when the locals cheer a goal, you look pleased too. That way everybody gets along real well. Okay, it's funny only to me, sorry. This is a song someone requested, and I want to send it out to the fellow that requested it. Sure, in fact, I'm going to do two songs he requested. I hope that's okay. But besides the guy that, I'm not digging around here, I have a point here. Besides the fellow that wanted me to sing the song, and I'm going to sing it for him, this is a song also by a friend of mine, and here we go. Here's my introduction in Italian.
Questa canzone è per il mio amico Dardo, Ernesto De Miscale, che visse a Firenze. Lui mi manca.
Claudio, I know for a fact Ernesto liked this song. So this is for Ernesto, and this is for the fellow that came to wanted me to play it. Here you go.
Hard times won't touch my family.
team. Unfortunately, they don't play football. But if you get a chance to go to New York, get the subway and go out to Coney Island and see the Brooklyn Cyclones play. It's much more the America that I want you to know than Burger King or Donald Trump. No, no, no. Donald Trump bad, Burger King bad, no, 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 McDonald's bad, Brooklyn Cyclones, yes, Z. The same guy that wanted to hear that song wants to hear this next song. When you get to my, I know I'm talking a lot, I'll try not to talk so much because you don't understand all I'm saying. I had a wonderful friend that loved this country that played here a lot. His name is Greg Trooper. And Greg and I wrote some songs, most of which went nowhere. This one's been recorded about four times. And you're thinking, yeah, you and Greg. No, no, no. I mean, other people besides Greg and me. And I guess Billy Bragg did the best version. This is gospel singer's time. Anyway, this is the second song that fellow requested. Hope he enjoys it. to see. That little foxhole became my island grave. Lee got out of jail, but a prisoner he became until he ended his own life. He used the ball and chain. Slanted eyes, can't you forgive and forget? And Lee said, oh, Mr. Holy Ghost, can you catch water in a net? Over here, over there, it's the same. Did what I could to make it better, even better. It wasn't a lot of work required when you got a piece of material like that. It was sounds like somebody's opening a flight case. And he was just a real special person that I adore and I miss a great deal. Let me see what I should do. This is a song. The Long Riders had a box set, and then I'll play some Mandel. I'll do this. The Long Riders had a box set come out 2 years ago and change, like 28 months ago, and it did really well in a depleted market. So we're very pleased that it did so well. It's called Final Wild Songs. Get it? And when the publishing and radio statements come in, you know, we're not famous people. So be it my Cole Porter's band, or me solo, or the Long Riders, you know, it is what it is. And but I do look to see which songs got the most airplay and which songs, you know, people seem to enjoy the most. And this is one of them. It's off of the last Long Riders album from 1987 called Two Fisted Tales. And the name of the song is Gunslinger Man. And it goes like this. Silver Smith and Wesson with a pole and a butt. Cut the polish shining from his hand and a nut. Don't you know? He's a gunslinger man and he does the best that he can, don't you know? He's a gunslinger man and he won the West with his hands. He used to be known for the strength of his tongue. Today set him apart with Russian immigrants. Try as they might, then the headman said, don't you know, he's a gunslinger man, and he does the best that he can, don't you know, he's a gunslinger man, and he won the West with his hand. He's thinking so loud that his teeth are gritty. Following silence calling from his sister's dawn. He's got his daddy wondering, what the hell is he on? See it in his eyes, see it in his verse. A minute and a half, showed up a ride in a hearse. He needs no badges to it.